All right, so we're starting.
We're starting?
Mm-hmm. So this is, we should say, welcome to Zoomer.
Welcome to Zoomer Philosophy.
Zoomer Philosophy.
With me, Orgel.
This is my son, Noah. Yes. And I'm Doug Lain, and this is the first episode of Zoomer Philosophy. We will see if it actually is ever aired. You're a Zoomer.
Yeah, I fall into that category of people. You fall into the category of either boomer or millennial, somewhere in between there.
I'm in between.
You're an in-betweener.
I'm a Gen Xer.
You don't really fall into anything.
The Gen X generation is the coolest generation.
Is that the case?
Mm-hmm.
See, now, I feel like you might have to prove that later.
We've got the fashionable gray hair without having the walkers.
You've got a real attitude problem, McFly. You're a slacker. You remind me of your father when he went here. He was a slacker, too.
Anyways, I'm still going to call you a slacker.
You can call me a slacker all you want. You know who else was a slacker? Marty McFly and his father, George McFly.
That's true. They were slackers. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is Marty McFly, he's a boomer. Michael J. Fox is a boomer at this point, right?
Is he?
Is he a boomer or is he?
Let's take a look.
Gen X.
How old is Michael J. Fox? He's Marty McFly. He played younger than he was.
Yeah. So he
if he had been born in 1965, he would be a Gen Xer. But he was born in 1961.
Yeah.
Which makes him a boomer.
Fascinating stuff.
You were born in the year?
2004.
Yeah. Which makes you quite definitely a Zoomer.
Yes.
Part of the Zoom generation.
Have you heard of this new Alpha generation?
No.
Just shitting everywhere.
There's an Alpha generation now?
Yeah, it's the baby generation. They're shitting everywhere.
Hmm. So, okay, but we don't need to worry about them. They don't have their own philosophy yet.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure.
One of the reasons I did this was to get him to read something I wrote, which he always delays if I don't make it into content. So,
what was it called?
It was called Gender, a Necessary Construct.
Question mark.
Question mark, yeah.
I mean, I have it right here. I can read the first sentence.
Yeah, okay.
First sentence is, we all know gender is a construct, but is it a necessary one? So you are arguing for gender abolition, the ending of gender as a category.
Mm-hmm.
And you say, you argue in here that if we got rid of gender as an identity, gendered mm-hmm. identities altogether, that it wouldn't have any negative effect on trans people. The transgender person, the person who wants to be, let's say if you want to be non-binary.
Yeah.
They're not actually trans in the sense that you would mean. They are either repulsed by the gender binary. They want to escape it. And you're saying abolishing gender
mm-hmm.
would be a way for people to be able to escape that binary.
Yes. But I see that's very troublesome for you since, you're all very masculine and something. Mm-hmm. That's what
when
he
I think
says.
About myself, I think about how masculine I am.
He comes in and he's like, look at my giant masculine hands. He comes into the other side
they're
of the room.
They're perfectly normal size hands. Nothing wrong with them. They're not small.
Maybe this bit would work in like 2017. I don't know when that, or 2016 maybe. Right after Trump was elected.
I think
jokes are dead, right?
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. I don't know about that. I think now we all go say, hey, like, go Brandon. Is Brandon kicking off with
who is,
this?
Who is Brandon?
I think he's either a new political candidate or maybe he's just an allegory for
Isn't
hating
it Daniel?
Bernie Sanders.
Isn't
Not Bernie Sanders. The other one. The one that's president now. I like Bernie Sanders. I'm not
Joe
the biggest
Biden.
One. Yeah, Joe.
Let's go back to gender.
Yeah.
So,
You never made me watch The Prisoner. How would I be able to discuss this with you?
We don't have to watch you don't have to discuss The Prisoner.
All right. I'm just saying. Does your audience love The Prisoner?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't do that kind of demographic.
You don't do the
analysis.
Demographic?
No.
Of the
I
prisoner?
Don't know what they like or what they don't like.
Oh.
I just know what I like.
You know what you like, and what do you like?
Spaghetti.
Oh, he likes spaghetti. Earlier he was ranting about Batman.
Yeah, Batman is good.
Which I find strange since he's a bourgeois scumbag, that Batman, who inherited all of his wealth from his parents and then continued to exploit the working class.
You think he had him killed?
No, I don't I don't think he had him killed.
You think Batman had his parents killed for his inheritance money?
I doubt that, considering it was in Crime Alley. And, you know, I think maybe it was the crime that did him in.
All right, so back to gender.
Yeah, gender. What up with
that? So you're against gender. You want to abolish gender.
Yeah.
And you think that people who are wanting to be non-binary or who are too attached to being either a man or a woman,
mm-hmm.
he or she,
yeah.
are out to lunch. They should give up on their identities.
Yes.
Whether they're cisgender or
being
trans.
So our philosophy, and we should stop spending so much time thinking about our personal identity when I don't really see why that matters, because it's not about who's saying stuff or who's doing something. It's about what they do or what they say. And you, like, what
do you
do, like, what, my point is that you are, will build your identity through, like, your life experiences, what you say, and what you think, and it won't be based off of, your identity will be based off of, like, the way that you experience the world and the way you talk about the world, and not based off of the way you think about yourself.
All right, but let me ask you a question.
Is, you know, my goal. Yeah.
So if I, let's say that we're in your world without gender.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say that I've decided one day I want to go on dates. So I'm going to get an app.
Yeah.
And then I get the app, I download it, and then I decide, well, I need to select what kind of people I'm interested in dating.
Yeah.
And let's say that I like, you know, the female type.
Yeah.
The ladies. That's who I would enjoy dating, mm-hmm. let's say. Well, without a gender identity, how am I going to...
It's very simple. But you select on the options. So here, I'm imagining these two options. Mm-hmm. Maybe there'll be a third option for titties and dick. But I'm thinking that it will probably be titties, dick, and then titties and dick. And those are the options you can choose. And you can, you know, you can choose multiple.
Okay, so what you're telling me, to put it in less crude terms,
yeah,
is that I would pick based on biological traits.
Yes.
And it would be broken down into multiple categories, not just two.
Yeah.
It would be people who had breasts and vaginas,
mm-hmm.
people who didn't have breasts but had vaginas,
mm-hmm.
people who had breasts and had penises,
mm-hmm.
people who have no breasts and have penises.
Yes.
And people who have breasts and no breasts and penises and vaginas.
Yes.
Those would be all my options, I think.
Yeah.
I might have missed one.
Yeah.
But that seems like it complicates things more than clarifies things.
You know what? I think that you might find that it wouldn't.
Why would we want to do this? I mean, what's the pro, what's the upside of getting rid of this very useful social category called gender?
Well, I think the upside would
be
that
how are we supposed to know who is going to give birth and take care of the little young ones, the little younglings? How do we decide who? How do we decide, you know, who's going to wear their hair long and who's going to get their hair cut short? How do we decide who wears the dress and who wears the pants?
I think that, you know what, maybe we would have some revolutions in fashion.
Oh, I so think. There'd be other kinds of clothing.
Yeah, maybe skirts, I don't know, something like
skorts.
That. Skorts. Skorts, maybe, yeah.
Sounds like a hell on earth. So, all right, yeah, skorts.
Well, to answer your other questions, how will we decide who wears long hair and who has short hair?
Yeah.
I'm going to take that seriously and say probably death match, you know.
Okay.
We'd have
whoever survives the death match.
Yeah, whoever survives.
Can cut their hair short and all the dead people can grow their hair long.
Yeah.
Okay, that sounds fair.
And then you marry the dead corpse. You know, I think it's legal in France engaged.
No, you can't
already.
Marry anyone with long hair, obviously.
Oh, is that
so? Yeah, no, because that would be a crime against nature.
Yeah, I've heard.
So, all right. So this is beginning to be clear. So we're going to eliminate gender. We're going to have the Tinder apps be based on all the different varieties of secondary sex characteristics.
Yeah.
We're going to have the people who wear their hair long be the ones who don't survive a death match. So why is gender such a big deal to Zoomers? Why is it a topic of such conversation? How many people do you know who are confused about what gender they are? How many non-binary?
More than you would think.
Like, how many do you think I would think?
I think that
How many people do you know?
How many people do I know?
All together.
Like, I think three.
Okay, I would say then of those three, two are confused about their
gender. Yeah, around two, yeah.
Okay, so.
So I think that we should, look, all their mental space is being used to try to figure out shit about themselves when it should be thinking more about me and why I'm so great.
So, okay, you know three people.
Yeah, I know around three people.
And two of them are non-binary?
Yeah, and two of them are non-binary, yeah.
Of those two non-binary, is one a boy and one a girl? Or are they both girls? Are they both boys?
I think one of them has, like, a very long, shriveled grape for genitalia. And then the other one has...
So are these imaginary people?
Yeah, no, you know? I know more than three people in reality.
Okay, but all right.
I feel like those are good statistics. All right. Is what I'm going on.
But where did you go with the, why did you bring up the grape?
Why am I bringing up the grape? Because you're asking me if they're a boy or a girl.
Right. Oh, I'm using that gender.
Yeah, identity. You're using that gender thing.
All right. So are they biologically male or biologically female?
And then I was saying that, and to answer to that, that they are neither, and instead a vegetable man, a vegetable person.
You know, this morning when we were having breakfast. Uh-huh. We went out for breakfast.
Yeah.
And you told me that here comes Todd.
Yeah.
And I shouldn't look at him. Don't, what did you say? Don't make eye contact.
Don't make eye contact with Todd.
Yeah.
Yeah, just don't do that.
And it turned out that Todd was...
An ant on the table.
An ant.
Look, we've been having a rough patch, me and Todd.
Okay. Seemed a little odd that you get so emotional about an ant.
Well, you don't know Todd the way I do. Todd's a skank.
Okay.